All right, guys, bear with me. I'm trying to figure this thing out. I made two scheduled lives and one is not working. So I have to delete it. How do I end this one? I don't know. All right, so, and I had some help, but they left. So just bear with me. You guys can even hear me. Where is my Creator Studio? I have to delete one. And I'll go off of this one. So videos, I'll show you here what I'm doing. So I made two, where's the lives? Two lives. Live. We're on this one. But this one I tried to create on the computer, but couldn't get it going on my phone. So we're going to delete this one. How do I delete it? Delete. Deleted. I understand deleting, blah, blah, blah. Delete video. Okay. So that should take care of that. All right. There we go. All right, sorry about that. Had to delete something. Friend Pat should be here any minute. Billy just left. Wyatt just left. We were getting some orders out. And I am playing with an Ohmie today. Not going to fully have it assembled, but mostly assembled. Because I changed part of the design. And part of this is figuring out the assembly process. Another way here. So, so bear with me. I'm going to do this. I had some help to help me with comments and questions, but I won't have that right now. So I'll try and keep up with that. I'll do some stuff. We won't be on that long, guys. Maybe I can log on here and see. I have a tablet over here. Let's see your comments. Hey, push mute. Still have those 15s. Yes, I still have the 15s. Actually, Billy's still here. He's selling X Series 15s. How much would you take for them?
300 a pair.
Each. There's Billy.
600 a pair.
No, that's too low. 700 a pair. 700. Make a deal. We want to sell them in pairs because people want twos and fours. If we sell one, then someone might say, "Hey, I wanted four." Or, you know what I mean? Just send a message.
If you are hanging out, you could read the comments if you want. That's better to say.
Dan Das K from Denmark.
Denmark. Oh. William Berg, I see some pop up here. Thanks for the shirt and sticker. Thank you, William Berg.
What up? Alan Eldridge.
What's going on, Alan? Thank you. $300 pair, he'll take 10. Well, we only got four. All right, so if you guys know, I have Sparked Innovations is my company, and we are making a product called Ohmie that is releasing basically now, but I had to change something on the housing. This is part of it. So the acrylic base, I sanded this to frost it so that it illuminates with the LED. On the circuit board, I don't have the full LEDs to illuminate that. I have to redo the positioning of the LEDs, but essentially they'll still illuminate. We had four of these thin arms to hold our big butt relays here. I reduced it to two arms on each side and a thicker arm of acrylic just for strength purposes. So what I'm going to do now is I'm trying to figure out if I can fit a relay in after, if I do the arms first, or if I got to put the relays in the arms and then put the arms in the housing. You know what I mean? So I might mess it up, but that's all right. So the thin stuff is cut on our laser. The thick stuff is cut on this CNC router here. So what I should do first is let's put this thick acrylic on. And I have some acrylic welds, which while doing this live, I'm going to do it sloppy because I always get like a little nervous and excited. And it's hot in here and I turned off the fan for the sound. And it's quite dusty right now. But that's all right. How's it look in the camera over there, buddy?
Good.
Good?
Except for you.
Me? I don't look good? Well, you shouldn't see me. You should just see this.
Yeah, we're good.
Right. Any OG questions, comments coming up?
OG Airbender, cool CNC buddy. Car audio guy. Have a good stream, buddy.
Car audio guy's from England.
Corey Jones, good afternoon from Barbados.
Barbados? Oh, yeah, it's from all over the place.
North Carolina. What else does it? Chicopee, Mass. Texas.
Texas. Only a couple things I know from Texas. Beers and...
There's a refresh swirl. Swirl. Somebody's complaining about.
A what?
A refresh swirl.
That's on there and not here, right?
I figured as much.
You're getting it, right? Yeah, all right, this is acrylic weld. This is the gel stuff. The end is all functified.
Second skin. See if we can clean it out. A little screw in there. I need a pick or something for this. There we go.
Netherlands.
Honduras. Straight clicking.
So the acrylic weld should only take a few seconds to hold. This is the gel stuff. I'm not sure if it takes longer. Seems like that side is holding. So far, so good. I'm dripping.
Yes, we want sandwiches. Straight clipping.
Oh, is he makes some good sausage sandwiches, right?
Sausage sandwich. Hook it up.
All right, hold that for a second. Those are gonna cure on there. I'm just curious how strong this stuff will hold. The idea is, let's get one of these open. People enjoy this, seeing this stuff? How's the camera view? I got a question for people out there. Have you done much acrylic work, acrylic fabrication, and custom pieces made out of acrylic? If you have, let me know. What is it? Did you do acrylic amp racks, acrylic sub box, acrylic trim? Do you light it up? I got two of those. That's the problem. They already ran into a problem. It's dripping out. So I have to amend my procedure here. It's fluffy. So it seems fairly strong. Strong enough. This one, that, and this has, I don't know how well you can see it on there. This has a notch, so it can slide on there. See how well I can get it.
William Estes made acrylic speaker brackets before.
Speaker brackets.
Amp rack. Kicker acrylic kicker logo with LED.
Oh, light up acrylic sign. I put on too much gel, I think.
Watching now.
So what I'll do is I'll just do this one side, see how it goes, see if it all holds firm. I think it will. It looked misaligned. Okay. You know what? While it's drying, I'll put the relay in, see if it messes anything up. Going in, all right. Camera. There we go. That part in. So it's real tight tolerances, so pressure fits into the center arm here. Hmm. And then the outers hold it. It's on there. So then these pieces go on the top and the bottom. And I don't have them right now, but there's going to be standoffs to hold it mechanically. Let's see if we get these to line up.
Hi, Billy and Tempe.
Are you watching at home? Mm-hmm. All right, so. See if you get a better view at home there. So anyone got any questions? You guys can ask me stuff not related to Ohmie here. Just car audio in general. Or my YouTube in general.
Where did babies come from?
Boys have penises. Girls have vaginas. Is there anything called a super chat coming through, Billy?
I don't know what that means. That'll be a highlighted thing.
Yep. OG Airbender, $2.
OG Airbender? Awesome, man. Thank you.
Spark Innovations coming up. There's another one. William Berg, $1.99.
William Berg, you're awesome. I got a lot of good supporters, so I did just recently start sending some gifts out to my Patreon supporters. So thank you to everyone on Patreon.
Dave Monroe, $2.
Dave Monroe, awesome, man. Hey, you guys don't have to do that at all, but I want you to let you know, for anyone that does do that or anyone on Patreon, I have a fund to help build up the channel, to do collaborations, to do all the special things that I want to do, all the plans. So now if you look on Ohmie here, so this, I'm not going to acrylic weld because I don't want to blemish it. So the another piece is going to go on the back just like that one, and I have them ordered. I don't have them here yet, but it's going to be a standoff, and they're going to bolt together, so that'll sandwich everything, hold it together, and then this should all be really firm. So I'm not going to complete this right now. I'm just putting it there to show you. I'll leave the paper on this one for now. But that's essentially what it's going to look like, unless we change some of these cosmetics. But yeah, you can see how that's going. It looks like everything. So this is the first test of this design, and it looks like it's going well. To me, anyway. What do you guys think? Just lining it up. It's a little tough, though.
Are you planning on releasing any more electronic products soon? HPA, HY, Power Audio.
We are releasing this soon. We put it on hold, but we have Fanny in the works. So a fan, the cooling fans. And then possibly something else with relays after that. Some timer circuits, things of that nature. So I'll leave that where that is right now. What I want to do is see the circuit board will go on there. But because the circuit board has things under it, you know, all the through-hole components sticking through, it needs something to lift it up. So I have these pieces will sit there and give it a shelf to sit on. And these are acrylic, so I'll acrylic weld these on. Makes it all one solid piece, basically. Why isn't Pat here? Is he at home watching this instead of being here? So that'll sit here. And what I'm actually going to do is use the water thin acrylic weld and just kind of put it in the crease. If I hold this like that,
Sonic welds are good as well.
Yeah, I don't have a sonic welder, unfortunately.
Sonic the Hedgehog knows how to weld?
Yeah. Well, if you use super high frequency ultrasonic sound wave, it basically melts plastic and can weld it together. And see, I just dripped that all over. So if I'm going to do this for production, I have to come up with a solution where it doesn't drip it like that. A way to clean it up.
How can someone obtain acrylic glue?
U.S. Plastics and a couple of U.S. Composites. There's a couple companies. If you look at most acrylic companies, they sell, they carry all the accessories like that. That one's on there. So the clear stuff, the water thin stuff really bonds faster, much faster than the gel. So I might use that for the bottom pieces in the future. I might build a jig, something where it sits in and protects it from dripping all over the place.
It's true.
I'm not the best acrylic fabricator. But my specialty here is coming up with the procedures of how to produce multiples. So that's what I'm figuring out now. Just got to assemble a few of them, figure out where the hiccups are.
Yep.
And if I need to make a jig, I need to make a jig.
Irish jig?
Essentially. So those pieces are bonding. Actually, this one's already bonded. This one probably only needs a couple seconds.
These cars running out there. One of your neighbors.
Okay. So then this will sit on top, and there it fits without the bottom of the circuit pieces, the components hitting the acrylic. Of course, you can't see it under there, but that's what it's doing. So now I can actually mount the board here to this. Because when I do that side, I can, you know what? I'll mount that side now. Why not? Just wonder if I should try the water thin stuff on here. Why not? That's part of doing this is the test, right? So this won't come out perfect. This is a test. And yes, I have built a couple Ohmies, but we've changed the design slightly each time to improve it. That's why it's taken a while to come out. Making it as best as we can. Let's do one at a time. And it's basically a chemical reaction that's like melting the surface layers of the acrylic into each other. Dissolving, I guess I should say. It's already on there. So it looks like doing this from the bottom is a little easier than that gel. And maybe if I leave the paper on, it'll protect it from drips. Actually, since I sanded this, I can go back and sand it again. And yes, I know I'm getting fingerprints all over this, so I would do it with gloves in the future. This is the music of the future.
It's already pretty solidly on there. Let's see how this goes.
You have a price for Ohmie yet?
Price, well, some of our dealers are pre-selling them at 160, but the regular retail price is going to be 179. Sit there, and they're pretty solid. Right. And let's mount the board, and then we'll call it a day from there. One at a time. So I have these that were machined out, and they'll sit in there. Plastic washer to protect the board. A standoff, which then the acrylic on top will go to. This one. Two. How's the comments? People signing off because they're bored?
Yeah, you got a couple. In and out, maybe connection.
If there's any super chats, call them out to me.
27 to 29
viewers. Thank you guys for sticking around. What I might do for a Patreon giveaway in the future, like I did a little gift for my Patreons, I might do one also just for any viewers, but maybe some Sparked Innovations products and getting some other sponsors like Straight Clipping maybe to help out with some gifts.
Harbor Freight Sander.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I use Harbor Freight for a lot of stuff that I know is like, you know, I know it's crap, but it only has to last a little while. If it's not too crucial of a tool, like a palm sander or their air tools, like an air blower gun. Their hand tools, their rubber gloves are just as rubbery as any other rubber glove.
Someone just joined. They want to know what you're building.
I'm building Ohmie. And what Ohmie is, just in case some of you don't know, so this is going to be the new Spark Innovations product.
It's the neighbor from down the block.
It's your Ohmie. What up, Ohmie? So you'll connect it in between your amp and your subwoofers, and remotely from a small switch on the dash, change from series to parallel wiring. You could have two amps, two woofers, or one amp, two woofers, or four speakers on it, but it'll change series to parallel wiring. Tighten these up a bit. So this mounts the board.
Why did you decide to make in-house versus outsource?
So I don't trust anyone to do what I'm doing right now. We can get a little bit more elaborate on the design if we do it this way. So I'll have that. There, and then one on the back, and that'll hold it. And then what goes here is, you see I have a small piece of this. We use excess power wire, the pure copper wire for jumpers. So it goes in between your amp and your speakers, right? But nothing in the signal runs through any electronics, runs through the relays via jumpers. Well, some of them go right from post to post. And these posts are what used to connect. So now I have the ability to go under. These have a nut that secures them. And they'll go there, right? And then from there, I will have jumpers go from those terminals to the relay. And this is an 8-gauge crimp terminal. So I'll crimp those, heat shrink them, and then so I'll be able to assemble all this once I cut all the wire and go and push all these on, which makes it all nice and secure. But that's the housing for now. Actually, without all that wire, it's a lot lighter than the other ones. So it's just acrylic and everything. But yeah, that's Ohmie. Let me go wide here. Talk to the people. So the idea of doing it in-house is the future goal of wanting to build up U.S. manufacturing and be a manufacturer and employ people and have people like Billy here, where we're going to look at larger industrial facilities soon to actually get assembly lines going and get more machinery to do stuff in-house, because of our designs are somewhat elaborate. I could have someone do the electronics, do the board itself, but again, the cost with that, the time, the turnaround. Right now, we're at the stage where I'll build 50 relay boxes at a time, so it's easy enough to do that in-house. The MOQ and time that it takes to have an outside source do it just wasn't appealing for our level. We'll entertain stuff in the future, but for final assembly, definitely something like this is elaborate and should be done here. If we go with a simpler design where it's just in a black box, like a heat sink or something, that's a little different. We'll entertain that in the future. Maybe different versions of the same product, like more industrial versions and then the elaborate showy version, you know. But I'm not going to wire up these now. That'll take me way too long for the video. So I'm going to stop here today. But we can see what Ohmie is looking like so far. These are the relays here are much bigger. These are 120 amp relays. This is a 40 amp relay. You can see the difference. So this I tested a 12K amp on each channel. We'll rate it at probably 8K per channel continuous. So that's going to be a big boy right there. How are we with the questions or comments and everything? We good?
Yeah, just a lot of people saying sexy, nice, cool. They like it. It looks good.
Good.
Healing.
Show you guys around a little bit. Detach this. Of course, my mic is backwards, so I'll speak up so you can hear me. We've been manufacturing, got some relay board pieces there. We cut out of this. So in case you're wondering, like this machinery, my buddy over in Sacramento, Steve Mead, is basically as the larger version of things that we have here. So he does a lot of the fuse blocks and speaker terminals, which I might order from him for a project. But he's doing 8-foot by 4-foot sheets. We're doing this size. So 15 by 31. And there's our circuit boards. This was cut from our laser. Another arm there. So that's our production place. Here's another Ohmie board that I had there testing. What about your setup? What about setup so your lithium battery wouldn't drain back to the regular battery? That's interesting you say that. I have a prototype product around here somewhere that addresses that. We're not ready to release that yet, though. That's going to be in the future. So here's parts for the relay boxes. And I believe some are in here. Billy did all these. We got the acrylic tops. Some other circuit boards. More stuff like that. Products for the ship box. Scion. So, yeah, that's a little... almost dropped the camera there. That's a little tour, and that's Ohmie. So we produce the... when we do full production, I have this table cleared, and we get a line going. And we just line up all those circuit boards and solder them up, place all the parts.
There's the ship box.
Use battery isolation circuit. You shouldn't be drawing from the main battery. Main battery, I don't
know who that's addressing, but isolator. Yeah, we're going to have some isolators. So I thank you guys for tuning in. I'm going to end up tuning out here in a second. I see you guys got some things you want to talk about.
Get some close-ups of Ohmie right now. Big relay. Eight gauge. How big this terminal is. You wish your HHR looked like mine.
Well, mine's shitty right now. I need, if you guys know someone in the Philly area that can do a clutch, that's a job a little bit beyond me. I do have my
Simple Man. Whoa.
Thank you, Simple Man. Oh man, that's so cool.
My summer wheels over there. I have my tires in the back to go put on. There's my bodywork. But I did make a custom hood. So, no, thank you, Simple Man. Really, thank you.
All you guys, thank you for all the support. So, Ohmie, like I said, I'm trying to figure that out. So we're trying to grow the company, Sparked Innovations. So if you're interested in, I mean, my YouTube is one thing. I treat that as a separate business. So like I said, any funds that come in there, I've been trying to grow the channel and do more projects like traveling, doing collaborations with people, getting stuff to test, more test equipment. Sparked Innovations is my brand. We're also still new and not cash flow positive right now. We're still in the negative. Hopefully Ohmie will solve that. So another way to help me out is go over to Sparked Innovations Facebook page and follow what we do. And if you like any of our products, you know, hit me up and place an order and we'll get you set up with those. And look out for new products we're coming out with, like soon. Ohmie. So, and then eventually I've had a build going on in the HHR for years, and I've had the product sitting for it for years. And I just haven't had the time to do it. That's coming up. Same thing with my brother, Billy. We had products to go into his Durango for years and just not able to do it. So unfortunately we have to part with the amps and woofers. So if anyone is interested, we got the X15 V1s for sale. We got four of the 15s right now, $350 each. And
let's mine for the old school SPL challenge.
So I'm going to try and do the old school SPL challenge. If you guys know old school stereo and 12V talk, you can go over there. And there's a little challenge. What can you do with amplifiers before 2005? And rated at 4 ohms, I think the highest watt class is 500 watts. So I'm going to use that.
But we have these for sale also. Sundown.
Which are amazingly solid amps, and unfortunately we just can't use them right now. So hit me up if you're interested. Good deal on those amps. Good deal on those woofers. And I got other woofers that I used in the $150 SPL challenge that I'm selling also. I just got to film another video clip. So real quick, before I sign off, updates are I got a lot of video footage I shot for doing the Scion and a lot of stuff for the cheap versus expensive woofers. What else did I film? I filmed with Derek Haddock, the Sundown Unofficial. Going to put together a video about explaining what is an SPL vehicle. And I forget what else. Subwoofer Myths, got that video coming up.
That kind of stuff. All right, any other things? We got Simple Man again coming through. Dude!
The man.
Awesome.
Thanks, brother.
So far, you're helping out enough that you might get a Ohmie sent your way one day. We'll see. Or at least a relay box. We're going to do stuff. I'm going to have Sparked Innovations donate a giveaway for the maybe for September. I think I'm too late for August, but we'll see what we can do for September. Any other comments, questions, anything you see, Billy?
Chris, glad you guys are doing what you're doing. It's been a long time coming. Yeah, we're trying.
Trying to do some cool products and trying to keep up with videos. It's tough, so I've been slacking with it. But the idea now is each video has to have value to it, that I see value, like knowledge and education and whatnot. So, you know, I have a couple in the works, but still, if you guys do have ideas, feel free to comment. And you know, some of the ideas aren't really in my means, you know, but that's the idea of building up the YouTube, is get the means, get the resources together to get test equipment, to get items to review, all that sort of thing. Oh, we got the Crystal Audio Solutions woofer. I have it in a box, so I can't show you right here, but it's a new brand they're doing up, and it's a really awesome looking woofer. I'm going to do a review on that soon. I got to build a little test box. We're going to play around with that. So that Crystal Audio Solutions woofer is here. I just got to get the time to build a box and test it. That's coming up as well. Are you guys going to do recones? Recones? No, I don't do recones or anything. If you ever need recones, there's two people that I always recommend. That's PSI or fixmyspeaker.com or RA Audio. Both those guys can do like a multitude of different woofers, and I get parts from them once in a while. So I don't do recones.
Crystal's been around for a while. Is that the new one with the TI frame?
New one? No. No TI frame. They have a 12-spoke. OG Airbender says Crystal's been around for a while. They may have, but they recently just came onto my radar just a couple months ago. So new to me, I guess I could say. But anyway, I'll play with their new model. They sent a prototype out.
I think that's it, guys. You want to sign off?
Peace out. Hi, Mom.
All right, guys. Have a good day. May the bass be with you.